We'll see the topic representation of complex number in the form a plus ib. Let z equal to a comma b belongs to complex number c, and this a comma b we can write it as a plus ib, where here a comma b both are belongs to the real numbers. Z equal to a plus ib, right? Now if we draw one horizontal line and vertical line, this horizontal line is denoted as real axis, and the vertical line, it is called imaginary axis. Imaginary axis, right? If you take any order pair in this one, it is that we know that a comma b, yes, it is a real number, b is the imaginary number. We can write it as a plus ib. Right? So the plane which denotes the real and imaginary are called argand plane. It is called argand plane. Right? In the complex number z equal to a plus ib, this a is called real part of complex number, and this b is called imaginary part of complex number. A is called real part, b is called imaginary part of the complex number, and the real part of the complex number is denoted by re of z, and here what is the re of z value? A. And imaginary part of the complex number is denoted by im of z, and it is b. Okay, z equal to a plus ib is one complex number where a is called the real part, b is called the imaginary part. Suppose if any one complex number z equal to, only if it is there, a is there, and we don't have the imaginary number, we can write it as plus I into c, right? Here we have only real part, so this is called purely real number. If you have only real value, it is called purely real number. If you have only imaginary value, let it be ib. We don't have here real part, right? And this one we can write it as 0 plus I into b. We have only imaginary value, so this is called purely imaginary number. Purely imaginary number.